even in the revolution, after the ministry, after the country revolved, we had to come to the counties. Of course, the constitution says that the national should make the policy. So we had all these documents, and we were just starting off, so we had to look at the national documents, and there were so many. So they kept piling up, and we wondered, how do we manage them? How do we put them in a way that they are easily retrievable and also useful to us as we start off the revolution and we go through these documents? So that was our problem, that we had all this pile of documents that in no good format for us to use. Yes. So our first thought at that time was then to have some sort of library, which we called a resource center. We identified a room and made it into a form of a library with shelves, and we tried to arrange the documents, the ones that were from national, the ones that we were able to get from other sources, and even the ones we were developing as we were starting. So we had them all arranged in the shelves in our room, which was like a library, and we called it our resource center. So that was our first step. But then still in this format, it was still kind of hard to find a document quickly and even be able to go through it, because the room was now getting full. There were all sorts of documents from all reports, meetings, and all these things. So we thought this was still not addressing our main challenge of how to find them in a retrievable manner. It was easier. So we explored the issue, then why don't we put it on a digital platform? So that was our first thought, that how do we get them into a digital platform? So with the help of some of our ICT colleagues, we were able to then set up a platform where we would upload these documents from each department. And we also need to have different levels of access. There are those for public use, but there are some that we just use within our department. So once again, we felt we must move a step forward. We must now make it into a way that then people have accounts and you're able to limit access to different kinds of documents. Again, once again, with help from the ICT, we are able to separate that. They now access the documents in an easier way. If you want our AWP, it's there. If you want our CIDP, it's there. Our soon-to-be-launched strategic plan. If I can access it quickly, I can confidently make a decision saying, based on these guidelines, based on this standard, this is what we need to move to do or to move forward with. We were still grappling with the issue that we want this to be our countywide for our whole health department. And we know that some of our field officers, where they are, they do not have this connectivity. So how do we make it still accessible for them? That's a big challenge for us. Two, there are still people grappling with digital technology, so that's still a challenge to some. It's still not 100% that all our colleagues are involved in this. Of course, some of the documents we want and we have are still in hard copy format. So we have to find a way how we upload them. And because we are not the authors, we must then get permission from the authors. Good advice for ourselves within our county, that we must cascade these digital footsteps down to the county, to the sub-county level, the facilities, and we are glad that this is something that our county has taken up through the ICT department to find a way that they will digitalize all our facilities. in the health sector, it's a good thing to digitize all our work. We are continuing with the increasing numbers of clients that we have to serve. And the manual ways becomes harder to keep our records. So I think digitalization is a good way to go. Be able to maintain our records and to respond to the needs of our clients in a faster manner. Because when you digitalize, you're able to aggregate data, to seek patterns, to see where changes can be made. So I would recommend that we continue the issue of digitalization.